Good day, Sir Julius Season. So I am Jovi Dela Cruz of 2BS BA of Pangasinan State University, and this is my movie criticism about the movie Dead Poets Society. This was originally written by Tom Schulman and later on created as a movie and directed by Peter Weir. This movie is actually derived from the concept of Carpe Diem, meaning seize the day, as a phrase used by the Roman poet Quintus Horatius Flaccus, or also known as Horace, that basically interprets that one must enjoy themselves while they have the chance. This movie was actually released 33 years ago because it was introduced to theaters in June 2, 1989, which amazes me because no matter how old the movie was, its lessons will never be forgotten, especially how it must shape the person's mind to step out of the box. The set was actually promising because all of us experienced going to school, so it sets the mood where we feel their presence as if we were there in a fictional institution in Welton Academy, located in Vermont. This was actually an all-boys preparatory school which started to introduce our main characters, Neil, Todd, Knox, Richard, Steven, Gerard, and Charlie, which the motto of the school is tradition, honor, discipline, and excellence. Most of the boys call their school the Helton, for which they are pressured with what I would like to call extreme spoon-feeding, with lessons, assignments, attitudes, and one notable motto which is conforming to tradition, to which a former student of Welton Academy, which is now a newly hired English teacher named Mr. John Keating, is opposed on doing so. For a very special understanding on how originality must be important. This is purely because Mr. John Keating is actually a character based on a real English romantic poet named John Keats, who enjoys doing poem about celebration of life and originality. Going back with the movie, Mr. John Keating, the founder of Dead Poets Society, when he was a student and became a teacher, is said to be an unorthodox, or contrary to what is usual, traditional, or accepted. But this ideology, when we think of it clearly, it can be proven right, in order to help the boys look at the world in a different manner and achieve greatness for what they believe in. Starting from the first scene of Mr. John's class where there were photographs of former students that has hope in their eyes, destined for great things and even invisible, but they already passed away. So it is essential here how Mr. Keating reminds them to make their lives extraordinary before it's too late. As I watched the movie, I was already inspired to do good things in life rather than sleeping all day and doing nothing. And for me, this was a thumbs up already, for it also benefits my positive thinking. Next, in the second notable scene, where they rip out the introductory page of the book, it is somehow symbolical that when reading, we must not always consider what the author thinks, but because we have our own mind. Similar, for example, creating a poem, which does not necessarily need to have a meter, a rhyme, a figure of speech. But in other words, if you love something and you want to be unique in creating something, it must importantly come from the heart in order to express it thoroughly, and it will not limit ourselves. And that is what I understood together with the students, and this can be observed also with Tom Anderson's poem, which the sentences he come up with by using his imagination and not just being ordinary, as a guide from Mr. Keating. Furthermore, the scene where the class is outside and having a march, where he teaches not only his students but also us, the viewers, to trust that our beliefs are unique in our own by not conforming to the beat of the march, but we can empower ourselves to think of other ways to express our very own self based on what we think is right. Now I'm going to discuss the downfall of the characters, where having to seize the day resulted to a disaster, as the students like Knox Overstreet becomes overconfident on romantic moves and kiss the girl named Chris Noel, where Knox, blinded by love, got punched in the face and made him suffer. Next is Charlie Dalton, also like to call himself Nuanda, as if he was experimenting himself to overcommit with Mr. Keating's teaching that he considers himself to be in control of any situation and believing that he will not face consequences due to his belief, so that in the end, he exposed Dead Poets Society in an unconvincing way and made fun of the principal, Mr. Nolan. Lastly is the tragic death of Neil Perry, which is one of the most shocking highlights of the film, where he has given himself to play the main role of a play but got scolded by his father. For his father wants him to be a doctor, and not realizing or having empathy for what his son wanted to do for his life. The situation is caused by the lack of understanding of Neil's father about seeing the world in a different manner, but focus on only one thing, which corrupts his son's mind, and this can be a great lesson for all of us. That we must remind ourselves to give others freedom to do what they want and what they love, because every people has something to say or meaning unique in small little ways. And so you must learn to listen. And the main idea here is that poetry or a role of a person is not something we just read or follow, but rather it has a direct impact on our lives. So that is all. That is my movie criticism about the movie Dead Poets Society, and I hope you like it. And